it. We're going to open iMovie, which is here in the bottom, and I'm going to go to create new movie, not trailer. All right, nice and loaded. I'm going to go to my import media here. And I already made a folder which has a headshot, a dance shot, and a clip, but you might have multiple clips from when you were filming your combos. All of them are imported. All right, we're gonna start with a dance picture. This is my daughter. I thought this was a funny one. I'm gonna drag it down here. This is kind of big, so I'm gonna go a little bit smaller so I don't have to have it quite so big. Great, and then from here, I'm gonna go to titles. And I want to put her name on there. Or actually, I just put my name. And because she's in the middle, I want to do something that's a little bit lower. So I'm going to drag it and put it literally right over top of the picture. Great. Now I'm going to double click it. And it will allow me to come up here and change it. So I'm going to put my name. And then I'm going to click on the bottom one. Now I also want to change the color here. So I'm going to highlight it and then go to here and change it to, let's put black, I feel like it's easy to see. Yeah, push enter. Same with the bottom one. So we're gonna go out here and close this. Go back and click it in case you'll lose it. There it is again. I'm gonna highlight my last name, go back to the pictures, go here to black, hit enter, and close it out. So now I have my name and a dance picture. So if I scroll all the way over here, I can play it by hitting the space bar, and there I am. Perfect. All right, now we're gonna go back to My Media, and we wanna pull in a dance video. So this is Lauren Mike. So I'm gonna pick maybe two clips that I like of this. All right, let's say I wanna stop it right there. Boom, I'm gonna click it. So now the focus is on the line. I'm gonna control right click, and I'm gonna split this clip. Boom, now I can split it, good. All right, so let's say I want to keep this going. I don't like that part, and I want to get back to here. That's where I want to start it again. Control right click, split clip. I'm going to take this one, which is now highlighted, and hit delete. Now that one's gone. So now if I go back here, hit the space bar. Good, and I can do the same thing over and over again. If I have multiple clips, I would just take it from here, pull it down. Yes? Now, we're going to take this because we don't want to use that music. So you want to highlight this little bar here and pull it all the way to the ground, to the bottom of it. And here, same thing, pull it all the way down. So now there's no audio. So let's say I had another clip. Let's pretend like this clip at the top is a different clip. Maybe I'd done two or three. I would just drag it down, drop it in. That you can also go here and you want to make sure the two arrows and the line, and you can drag it. If you don't want to cut and clip, you may also drag. Boom. And also don't forget every time, take it to mute. Yep. All right, so we're making the transition between our picture and our first clip. You want to go to transitions here at the top. So I am going to cross blur just here, and all you do is drag that transition right in between. It'll say 1 second and it will do that. Yep. Also, if this ends up dragging over, you want to take it and make sure it's only the length of your picture. You don't want it to be too long. So what that will look like, go back to the very beginning, space bar. All right, so there's my picture, my name, cross blur, my first clip, my second clip, my third clip. Yes, all the way through. Now, if you feel like these are too choppy, try to make them, you know, really nice going into each other, but you can also, you don't want to do too much, but you can also like cross dissolve is a good one. And you would stick that in between these two if I felt like it was too choppy going from one clip to the other. So the way that that would work is first clip, and then it would cross dissolve into the second clip. Go back to my media. We're going to finish with a headshot. This is one of my old headshots. I'm going to pull it down, drag it. Boom, there it is. Now, what it's doing is this zoom. So you want to double click the picture and it's going to, you want to go to fit. Okay, so crop to fill, fit, and then you're going to go back. Let's see what that does. Boom, yeah. So if you want to make it a little more fancy, you can see it says start and end. So start, you want to do, I would do about here, make sure you can see the top. And then you have to kind of, it's a little bit difficult to get to the end, but you have to click it till it highlights there. And when you end, you want to make sure you have all of it. So I would start with that, and then I'm going to click return. So what that does is kind of the zoom in effect. So if I'm going from here, it's going to give me that fun kind of zoom, and you can play with that. Now let's put a title on it because you want to put your name and your Instagram handle. Because my picture is in the center, we either want to go kind of far to the left or far to the right. This might be fun. It may not work, but let's try it. All right, so you're going to drag that title right on the same as your name. Yep. And I'm going to double click it. And the name is going to be Casey Noblet. And then the description is going to be your Instagram handle. So I'm going to do at Casey Noblet. Hit return. All right, let's see what that does. So we're going to come back over here. Kind of like that. That's super fun. Thanks. So right now, just looking at our layout, we have our dance shot with name fading into our dance clips, which you can fade or go immediately into your headshot, which I have the start and stop, and then I have my name and my Instagram handle across it. Now we want to put audio. Okay, so you're going to go to audio because right now we don't want to use this music that was for the solo. Because it's going to be too choppy. So you want to do one song, which here you can see the little music tab is going to be under the whole thing. So I have a lot of music in here. You can go under this music, you can go under sound effects. Jingles is one. There's a bunch of different ones. You can see transportation, textures, effects, work, ambience, theme music, all kinds of things. So I'll just go to jingles for now. Anything that's in the sound effects category is not going to be pulled from YouTube or any of those because they're royalty free. So let's play Buddy. We'll just do Buddy for now so you can see how it works. So this is going to be your audio. It's a minute and three, so it will kind of take a lot of this. So you're going to drag it to the bottom and drag it so it's the same length. Okay, so now it's underneath. I'm going to go to the end and drag it so that it's the same length as mine. And I'm going to make this a little bigger so we can make sure that's the exact same length. Boom. And what I like to do is also fade. So if you go here, you see that tiny little dot. You want to just fade a little bit. Boom. Yep. So shrink it back a little bit. So if I start this at the very beginning, which would be here, push the space bar. This doesn't exactly go with this combo. I just want to kind of show you an example. Here's my three clips. Then it would finish with me. Then it ends the same time. So let's say I didn't like that track or I wanted to move it. You can also move this back and forth so that it fits. So if there's like a crash or something you want to line up with it, that's the best way to do it. But for now, we'll just leave it that. When you're ready to upload it, you'll go here. I would save it as a file first. Yeah, so if you're going to save this as a file, click file. I wouldn't upload straight from there. You're going to name it Casey Mini Reel. And then all this should pretty much stay the same. And then you'll go to next. And then it will start saving it. I'm gonna put it in my downloads folder. And then you can airdrop it to your phone. You can share it to YouTube. You can share it to Instagram from your computer, any of that. And then up here will be the progress. All right, hope that helped with your on-camera dance challenge. Thanks.